ready to go too. Paul Dvorsky with him. Stephen Walkham. We're underway quickly. Niedermeyer, Regeer, Gordon, Doan, and Draper, the checking lineup front for Canada. The check, Koivu, Solani, and Lehtinen. Numanen and Timonen are the two defensemen for Finland. They are, of course, in the white jerseys. Team Canada, the home team, red.
I think this is the first time in a major international tournament between these two teams where the Finns think they can win instead of hoping they can win. And there's a huge difference in that mentality. We'll see tonight whether the hope or the think ends up being the difference.
Olli Jokinen comes on. He's number 12 for Finland. Peltonen and Tuomo Ruutu on the wings. The defense have changed up also. Salo is with Vananen. Team Canada in their zone with this face-off. Joe Sakic. Again, Lemieux. Winning it cleanly. This is Adam Foote. A stalwart defenseman for Team Canada. He's been great, solid every game. Back into the zone. Vananen slapped it off the boards behind the net for Sammy Salo. He got it high on the boards and it did not get out. It's kept in, but a blind pass didn't work from Lemieux and it shot down the ice. Foote missed that. They wave off any icing. Finland on the attack, but here comes Sakic galloping away to the line. Getting to center with a pass. They get away with it. Mario sets it up. Score!
Has been fairly quiet the last two games offensively, but he can thread the eye of the needle with a pass, and when you get it to Sakic, it's not going to be on a stick very long, as you can see by that shot.
Well, one of the quickest releases in the National Hockey League, a miscue there, and that let Mario Lemieux have a little more ice than the Finns would like, and Sakic, as I mentioned, Harry, he's got one of the best releases in the National Hockey League, and we just witnessed it.
All right, Harry, what a dandy pass that was from Mario. He took one look. Right on the take. And the time of the goal was 52 seconds. Canada attacking again right in front of the net. That was broken up. It'll be cleared out. Tamu Solani gets it to center ice and dumps it in wide of the net. Here comes Brodeur way out to move it up off the glass down the ice. Teppo Numanen. Long pass. That's onside barely. Shot back into the finish zone. And again, they wave off any icing. Finland trying to get back now quickly if they can. Great start for Canada in this championship game. Joe Sakic getting the goal. In behind the net. Canada don't get it out. Long shot. Another one. Great save. There was two saves.
Shows you that he looks like he's in mid-tournament form as he makes two big stops after Canada had trouble on the defensive zone coverage. The giveaway right there, and there is the best stop of the night. That looked like it was in.
Is there a better goalie in the world that has the ability to scramble in those situations?
He made the first save. That is correct. And the big rebound looked like a pure setup for a goal. Then he made that dramatic save. Brodeur has been fantastic.
Well, it's good to see him play that way. You know that he's not 100%, but he sure looked like it on that one.
Let's have one more look at this first Canada goal because there was a miscue just inside the blue line. And here comes Canada, a nice pass, a give and go. And Mario Lemieux here is just going to dance by his check. And that's where all the opening ends up. And then the Finns in the back check are not picking up their assignments.
Sakic has given Canada a 1-0 lead at 52 seconds from Lemieux and Brewer. Better save by Brodeur. Lemieux got the puck out of the zone, then was hit. Jokinen went down, though, and and the play goes offside at the Canadian blue line.
Well, I think the Team Canada got a little scare against the Czech Republic in the semifinals, and I've always thought a scare is worth a ton of advice from the coach, and I don't think Pat Quinn had to talk to him very long about the fact they have to play better tonight if they want to win.
For Sakic, his fourth goal of this tournament. Canada starting up again, led by Regier. Shot into the zone by Thornton. Another chance there, flying off the wing with a shot. Three Finns come back in over the line. The setup goes to Solani off the skate. Missed him, just missed him. And he was coming hard off the boards. Finland spreading out, the five of them. They get the puck in. Shane Doan threw a hit and stays on there to take that pass. It hopped away from him, though, and got down the ice. Timo Tiiminen back there for Finland. He's with Teppo Numanen, and they get together to bring it out. Two passes back and forth. The two defensemen get it up across the line. The shot is deflected up over the glass into the netting.
Well, many are wondering how Martin Brodeur is going to handle a puck. I talked to him this morning. He had the same injury in junior. And what he's going to do is not grab the puck with his glove or the stick with his glove, but just use the glove as leverage, and his top hand will do all the work, as you can see there. And that's how Martin Brodeur is going to handle a puck tonight. He's really good at it, even one-handed.
He's the best in that department, too. Everybody talks about the way he can handle a puck. That is not new. And he's having a tough time. He knows he has to play with maybe a little pain, he said. But that's okay. He's done it before.
And Kelly Rudy mentioned about getting up from when you're down, when you use your hand, your glove hand. Well, I had mentioned that to Marty as well this morning. He says he always uses his fist and just pushes himself up back into position with his fist. So he doesn't think that's going to be a problem, Harry.
Here's how good Brodeur is with the puck. He got some Norris Trophy votes.
The Richards line on for Canada. And he's on the puck along the boards near the corner. Left it there. Richards gets it back again. He's covered this time. Finland in a little trouble maybe with this forechecking 3-0 for Canada. At the line, the long shot by Erik Brewer didn't miss by much. And Foot is back. He has to come back now, play it back for Brewer. He gets away from one forechecker. That was Hagman in there, a good skater. And Canada in on the rush! And that'll come off with that rush from the far side. And Kiprusoff just did get out of the way. There has been just the one shot on goal so far by Canada. That by Sakic, his fourth goal. Canada leads 1-0. We played 4 minutes of the opening period. Puck is slapped in by Billy Peltonen. Nearly mishandled by Bullmeister in front of his goalie. No harm done. Centered again, knocked down and cleared out off the stick of Numanen, the center. And he had to come back. Tuomo Ruutu had to wait too long and then lost it. Kiprusoff comes out of the net to stop the puck back there. Tried to go high, did go high, but it doesn't get out. Canada on the attack, forechecking again. This shot by Sakic is blocked. Into the corner and Sakic after it. Sakic getting loose, pulling away from his defenseman, Tiiminen, who is all over him. Again, Lemieux setting it up. Mario comes back out from the corner, back in the line. Another dandy pass, slapped in wide of the net. There again is Sakic, shovel it over. Oh, big stop there. Knocked high and down the ice, and the play stopped. But this line for Canada looking awfully sharp. Joe Sakic, Mario Lemieux, and Jerome McGinley.
Canada's size up front may really help them in this game tonight, recovering pucks.
They win the faceoff, but unfortunately for Canada, it got by the two defensemen, and Regier comes back. Draper flipped it high. Thornton won't get that. Backing up is Aussie Bannon, played it to the line. It's tipped out to center ice. Canada taking charge early and looking sharp in this championship game. And the goal scored in 52 seconds by Sakic. And they're on the puck again in the zone. There goes Doan. Around the net, Draper. The two of them back and forth with the passes. Again, Doan backhands it around the net. Joe Thornton twisting and turning back there, and he's strong. He's coming out. He shakes off a check. Thornton doing big work with the stick. Hauls away from the check again, and it's played on the boards and stopped at the line by Regier. However, knocked down by Thornton. Coming in. A pass. Back that shot stopped by Kiprusoff. In front again. Thorne nearly had one. It's back inside the line, and there goes Regier. He takes a hit but keeps going. Slap high to the boards. All Canada here in the early going. We're nearing 7 minutes. Canada on the puck. Another long shot. Big rebound. And cleared away by Lehtinen down the long side. And he goes after it. He lost it inside the Canadian blue line. Team Canada for real tonight. They had a slow start against the Czech Republic, but not tonight. Here's a chance. Back pass in front of the net didn't work. In around the goal, Elleranton trying to play it back out and does to the line. Long shot by Lindin, scores! Tipped in front, and Finland ties her up.
Pretty hard to see who tipped it. It might have been Rico Hall who got a stick on it. He was in front. It was a good low shot by Lidman that probably wouldn't have gone in had it not been tipped. But there was a pile of guys between the shooter and the net.
And a collision back at the point. Open the point shot up. Keep an eye on Elleranta as well. 22 to the right of your screen. There. I believe tipped it right in front of Martin Brodeur. We'll take another look, Harry, but...
I've been tipped twice.
I think you're right. I think you're right on the first tip. It might have been Hall early. There.
6:34 is the time of that tying goal. San Luis plays the puck out of the Canadian zone down to center. Richards bumped off the puck. It's in deep though in the finish zone. In around the net, Canada in to pick it up. Slapped away by Newman. That didn't get too far, but then he's lifted down the ice. 1-1 tie now. Elleranta gets credit for that goal by Finland. And Lidman took the shot from the blue line. Aki Berg also got in on the play. There's Sakic trying to get it back with Mario. Mario centering pass! And the shot not hard by Iginla. He didn't get all of it. Set up perfectly, though, and it was caught by Miikka Kiprusoff. Faceoff is deep in the Finland zone to the right of Miikka Kiprusoff. 1-1 is the score. Sakic and Elleranta. Puck is tapped up along the boards and cleared out by Finland quickly. Down they come. Juri Lehtinen got it in over the line. Solani tried to take his man off the puck. Lost a chance to move it out front. However, in the corner, Lehtinen kept going. He's stopped by Niedermayer. Shot around the boards, this near side. Salo comes in and takes a solid hit for doing that. Cleared at the net and tipped away by Niedermayer. He lost it. And it's recovered by Regier, his defense partner. Finland attacking well now, forechecking well. Three Canadians tear off, though, down across the line. Draper was hauled down. Couldn't get back up to get a chance at the puck. And Canada has to come back. Played ahead to Sakic. Good move by Sakic. Beautiful stick handling. Again, Le fires one. Again, it's deflected high. Over the glass.
Saku Koivu has been announced the first winner of the Jean Beliveau Trophy that will be given annually to a player who does the most for his community. And we all know that Mr. Koivu is a great citizen of Montreal as well as a great hockey player. And to win a trophy named after Jean Beliveau, much better than that.
Numinen moved the puck in a hurry for Finland. They get it in deep. Brodeur out to watch it. Not to the side. Two Finns in forechecking now, but Sakic will pull away. Elleranta doesn't stop him as he dropped it back. Moving up. Brodeur took a chance with that second move. However, Canada shoots it in. Out is Kiprusoff. Played along the boards, and three Finns are up there to go. Down across the line, a shot in a little bit too far that time for Ruutu. He went in though to pick it up, did get it centered, but nobody out there in front. Cavalier missed a chance, he'll get another. Nope, he missed that pass. And it shot down the ice. That'll be brought back.
Well, the Finns now, their confidence level suddenly has gone up a whole notch. It looked like this game was early over in the first 5 minutes. But a collision here by Canada at the blue line, and then Finland is able to recover the puck down low, get it back to the point, D to D, and Smith is still recovering at the point, and there's the double tip, we think, on that play, and Elleranta is going to get credit for the goal.
And Hall should get the assist in place of Burke.
On the face off. Finland shooting it in. Canada now backing up a little bit as we approach the halfway mark of the first period. Shots are even, five apiece. 1-1 the score. Again, shot into the zone by Ryan Smith. Finland back to pick it up and clear it out. Bullmeister turns all the way back and gives it to Le Cavalier. Takes his time through the pass up there. That works and along the boards. San Luis couldn't stop that clearing attempt. And it's fired back up there. Le Cavalier tipped it in front of them. We'll try to get that pass in front. Didn't quite work. Here comes Hinton, and he takes a hit. And the play is icing.
Well, he looks like he's in a little discomfort on the bench. This is what we think happened as Aki Burke stood up, and there's the other body check there as Tuomo Ruutu ran into him. And it'll be interesting to see, although he hasn't left the bench. That's good news.
Faceoff comes right to Sammy Salah by Hintonen. Doesn't get out. Swept back in deep by Brad Richards. Canada has to back up. Get out of the zone. Regeer has knifed it ahead. It's shot in then. Kiprusoff again out to play. Ripped on the boards and tipped out by Nicholas Hagman. Canada, San Luis, brought it in, shot it in deep, and heads off to the bench. 9:34 left in the first. It is a 1-1 tie. This championship game for the World Cup of Hockey. Lifted away by Lehtinen this time. Canada waits. Both teams are changing quickly. Eric Brewer made that pass. In deep again, thanks to Joe Thornton, but he was hit and couldn't chase it, and that's another rising call. Saku Koivu and Jiri Lehtinen on the other wing. Eric Brewer for Canada left it on the boards. Thornton's pass doesn't work. There's Solani trying to get some room. He might find it. He fell just as he tried to get inside on the last man back to stop him. 8:55 left in the first. 1-1 the score. Finland coming on. Gave up the first goal to Joe Sakic in 52 seconds, and Canada was taking full charge. Then Elolantis tip in, and great confidence now by Finland. And they talk about the confidence since coming into this championship game. They feel good about themselves.
Timo Tiimonen leads Finland in scoring and leads the defensemen in this tournament in scoring. And their defense corps, with the two assists on the first goal, although they may change one of them, now have 15 total points from the blue liners. That is far and away the best production of any defense corps in this tournament.
This team from Finland is a very quick team. Canada starting up, led by Sakic once again. Lemieux got a stick on that, made sure it got in there. But Aki Berg was back. Berg left it right there, and it's tossed high down the ice. Batted down at the blue line by Big J. Bullmeister. Only a total of 11 shots so far in the game. Only 10 left in the first. Six of them by Canada. The goal of the first shot of the hockey game. Sakic and his fourth. There's a chance in close. This one flipped high by Jokinen off his stick. Niedermayer missed it. On it is Ruutu. Behind the goal, he poked it a bit too far to make a play. And Canada just has to shoot it away and down the ice. This is reversed now. Canada is back on its heels a bit.
Well, ever since the Finns scored, they certainly look like a different team. One of their better performers, Jokinen, he got 26 goals last year for Florida, and that's the second most goals scored by a center in the NHL. And you can see what he's done in this World Cup. So he has really improved recently and is one of the key members of this team.
Kapanen comes on with Hintonen and Hagman. It's another quick line for Finland. Back down the ice for Canada. Get the zone okay along the boards. Again, the pile up on the board. Sakic did get it loose. Knocked it back to the line. Flipped high by Hannon. Finland will take over. First pass comes to Hintonen. He got it up to center high, and Bomeister didn't know where it was. It's given up there. The quick shot by Kapanen was deflected just wide. And Canada again having some difficulty with the forechecking Finns. Moving up, Bomeister. Looks like he wants to go. He got as far as center and dumped it in wide of the net. Moivu's back on the ice and got the pass back for Numanen. Tried to go to center. Lehtinen was bumped, didn't get to the puck. And here's Brewer coming back again. Flipped it ahead. That's broken up. Lehtinen centered it. Goes in front of the net with the pass. It's kept in at the blue line. And shot in deep by Sammy Salo. Finland looking strong now and coming on. That is Koivu who fell to his two knees. And Canada gets the puck out. But that's all. It'll be Finland back to pick it up. It's golfed back down the ice. Adam Foot turning. Got a quick pass away. Now Finland is changing. There was some time for Thornton. He didn't realize that. Shot it in and took off to the bench himself. So both teams changing, and here's Finland moving up in a tie game, 1-1. That'll be offside. It just came out a little bit.
Well, you saw lots of Finland on your overseas journey. But they look better now than they did early in the tournament.
Exactly the same, Harry. From day one, they're playing this very conservative trapping style slash Calgary Flame hockey. And that's what's made them successful so far. And they've slowed this game down to the pace they want once again here in this first period after they scored.
They're pretty good at the forecheck when they decide to do it, but they make good decisions. If there's no hope, they get back into the trap.
Canada has such a strong start. Came out flying and were rewarded quickly. Nearly got another on several chances. Finland tied the game, and now they are the stronger of the two, it seems. Once again, Gagne comes in deep. Takes a bit of a hit along the boards by Tony Lippman. Shakes that off. The puck is loose behind the net, and the Finns grab it. It's lifted high down the ice. Nearly a chance for Mikko Eloranta. He just missed it. And the faceoff comes inside the Finnish blue line. Canada wins it, Bomeister. He goes in wide of the net. Nearly set up a rebound for Mario Lemieux, who gets the puck to Ginla. Back in there, Sakic and Lemieux out front again. Right in front, the Ginla had another chance. Went down on one knee, and Kiprusoff grabbed the puck. It wasn't hard to him, but he smothered it.
And it wasn't as tough a stop as by Kiprusoff as it might have been. As you're going to see, there's the pass. The Ginla's going to shoot it and go to the net. But a real good play by Olli Jokinen. He wouldn't leave the Ginla and tied him up without getting the penalty.
Tied up the stick very effectively. 20-year-old Bomeister coming back to pick it up. And here we go again, Mario and Joe Sakic. Mario to Sakic. Getting set, Sakic looking back, hangs on to it, nobody opens, so he made a wise move by shooting it in deep around the net. The Ginla was tied up in front of the goal, and Finland, there's that defensive play again, just getting it out to center, taking advantage, Hintonen, he got across the line. However, they are offside. See the style of this game now, nobody walking away with this thing. Puck in front of the Canadian goal. And that's Eric Brewer taking his time. Laid down the ice. Heatley back on. Got tied up trying to go for it. And Canada will have to come back to regroup again. Now it's moved up. Long shot into the glove of Kiprusoff by Ryan Smith. That was not a problem. All given credit for the Finland goal. Now Canada attacking again. Heatley! That came close. He got it again and fired the pass out in a fashion that got by everybody to center ice and down inside the Canadian line. Good try by Danny Heatley. Face off to the right of Martin Brodeur. He came out of the net to sweep it away out of harm's way. And Canada starts up. Joe Thornton's pass was not great. Was in behind Doan, and he did a good job picking it off on the boards for Draper in there. Thornton comes in to help, and he's the big strong guy after the puck. Draper knocked it over to him around the net. There he is again. The center net. It got to the line. No shot. The first one didn't come off, and the second was blocked. That by Niedermayer. Dumped back in by Canada. And back is Lidman. Now Canada catching fire with the Thornton line, but they're changed and gone off. And there's the first penalty coming up now against Finland. first one of the game called here, and I think maybe interference.
Well, the Canadian power play 4 for 18, and I think Tamo Solani may be the perpetrator in this crime.
Without question. The hook waltzing into the penalty box.
The hook in him pretty good, too.
Puck recovery's been huge for Joe Thornton in this first period, and you sense that perhaps he may do something special for his team because he is owning the smaller Finnish defense here in period number one.
You're right, Greg. He's so strong. And he works so hard. Hooking, they're going to call it. Solani, the first penalty. 16:38 is the time. Canada, 4 for 18 on the power play in the tournament.
And the Finns have allowed 20 times shorthand.
So a little over 3 minutes left to play. Look out, there's a bouncer in front of Brodeur. Had to go down to be careful. Almost had to go down on all fours. Cavalier on there with Adam Foote, and they're coming out. Cavalier waits, pass gets up near the line. That might be offside. Tendy, they're going to call it back, icing.
Well, it's amazing with the offensive talent that all the teams have that the power plays are very average. I know the penalty killers do a good job, but
goaltending, Harry, you always say the best penalty killer is your goaltender. I've heard you say it a million times. We've got some pretty good ones here tonight.
Yeah, and that's probably the main reason why.
9-6 of the shots at this moment for Canada, which is the home team, in red and coming out. Left wing pass to start him off. Sakic gets the zone, drops it back. San Luis knocked it down with his glove, backhands it ahead near the net. That stopped at the line. Nice play by Niedermayer to keep it in. Mario goes to him again. He tried a second pass. That didn't work. And it's shut out. And down the ice by Hall. Canada moving up on the first power play of the game. The game tied 1-1. 2:25 left in the period. Sakic let it roll over to Lemieux. Pass back to the line. San Luis take the shot. Pass it off. And now they're forced to go back because it's shot by Hintonen. Canada regrouping with a new line. Richards dumping one in wide of the net as Heatley takes his man in on the boards, but the puck goes to the Finns and they get it out again. 2 minutes left in the period. In the penalty, 35 seconds. Solani in the box for hooking. Brad Richards stepping up to center ice, drills it in. And the referee, Walkham, had to be quick to duck away from that hard shot. It's the Finns coming out. Three of them are going to go up. The center ice now one fades back, and they get over the line with Lehtinen giving it up. Back out for Canada. Down they come, led by Danny Heatley. He's over at the far side and going to the boards, and that blind pass didn't work. Shot down the ice, and the penalty is just about done. Not a shot on goal by Canada. Now it's over. Solani is back out. Backhanded in by Hannon. And that's called into the Canadian zone.
And Greg, you got to know that the Finnish team is far more pleased with a 1-1 finish at the end of the first period than Team Canada, the home team, especially when Canada got the first goal.
Absolutely. They were thinking in their locker room, let's weather the storm the first 10 minutes, get through it, and then let's see how it is after one period. Now suddenly the confidence just keeps going up and up here for Team Finland.
Faceoff is coming up to the right of Martin Brodeur with a minute 15 left in the first period. It's back to the line in for Solani, but he didn't see the puck come in there. He was watching Adam Foote, who was all over him. Now it's cleared out by Canada. A minute left in the first. That play is offside, a little slow moving at the Finnish blue line.
Harry, in terms of matchups, we're still seeing Thornton against Koivu, and we're seeing a lot of the Mario Lemieux line because they seem to be hot so far in this first period. Would you go head-to-head like this in this game with Canada's depth, or would you just roll it over?
Well, I think that you there's reasons to do both. I can see why they want Draper against Koivu, but they may get away from that and not worry about as much about that matchup as the one that the Finns are trying to get.
Solani nearly picked one off at the blue line. Now he does take it. And he turns with the pass that's intercepted. Thornton got it ahead. Doan rolled it in, hoping Draper would get to it. He's in there at the same time as Timonen. Draper went down on the hit. stopped at the blue line. Canada keeps it in. 30 seconds left in the period. And Team Canada forechecking. A 1-1 tie. Shot to the line and by Niedermeyer and down the ice. Finland making just one last change. Only 15 seconds left in the period. Sakic is on the ice, dumped it in on that tip in, and then Regier stopped it. Fired it in around the net. Here's a chance. Ginla was out front, but he was checked before he got a stick down. Cleared up on the boards, and Finland will bring it back out to center ice, and that should do it for the first period. The team is at full strength. Second period underway. Back to Scott Niedermeyer ahead. To Doan. Shane Doan dumps it in wide of the net. Up there is Draper looking for it, but it'll be Finland trying to clear it. That backfired a little bit. Poked in by Doan again. He dropped it back, and Doan is behind the net, trying to come out front. He is checked at the side of the goal, and that'll be cleared out. Down comes Yuri Lehtinen. Fired the puck in as he hit the Canadian blue line, and Regier was back to touch it up and leave it for Doan again, who came all the way back. Doan ripped it on the glass, down to center. They move up quickly. Nearly getting in was big Joe Thornton. He reached for that big long reach of his and just missed escaping the finish check. Puck to center ice. They back in. Scrappy now, play. Close checking again. The Finns love to play that game. They're changing. Canada's fans trying to get them going. Ruutu tried to center again. He backed it up into the corner. Taken away by Pultinen. Side of the net. Brewer checked his man. Puck loose, and Finland has it at the line. Dumped in Mackie Berg. Behind the goal. Trying to center is Jokinen again. Well, they tie him up. However, Ruutu did get it back. Up comes Berg. He couldn't get a shot at the net. And the Canadian players are finding the Finns tough to contain on their forechecking. It's centered. That low shot just wide of the net. Ruutu all alone right on the tape with the pass. And he missed the net. 1-1 tie nearing 2 minutes of the second. Finland getting a good start. Canada got a great start in the first. But it's the Finns this time. Kapanen goes in. He kicked it loose. Had a stick tied up. The Finns are on it in the Canadian zone again. Around the net. Over comes Bollmeister. He checked his man. In there is Hentonen. He lost it. Backed up on the boards. San Luis is bumped around a bit by Hagman. And he fell. Hagman knocked the puck loose. Back out front, though, and it's cleared out by Richards. He was stopped in his tracks near center ice. Hagman nearly got it inside the blue line. Gagne, he's tied up just outside the finish line, and the checking continues to be close as we start the second. Nearing 3 minutes. 9-8 are the shots right now. So Finland with the only shot in the period so far, and we've played 2:37.
Well, the Finns are showing the Canadians that they like to forecheck when they can get two guys in early, because they hemmed Canada in for a long stretch. Didn't end up getting much of a chance to score, but had the puck and recovered it two or three times.
And if that's the case, Marty Brodeur is going to have to be active, Harry, when handling the puck. And that was a big question in the first period, how he could do it with a bad wrist. So far, so good.
Koivu won that faceoff in his own zone for Finland. Canada's Thornton line on again, of course, with Koivu on. Salani and Lehtinen. Finns get the puck up to center. Elranta coming down the left side as they make another quick change. And there's Hall. It's the only thing that Finland can do. Look out. It's in front again. And on the short side, Brodeur had to be careful with a stick twice. Finland changing quickly, trying to get away from Thornton. Canada back in. Score! Oh, my. That's not a good goal. But it's a goal.
Finns got a little too aggressive on the pinch, and all of a sudden they got caught with three men in, and Niedermeyer joins the attack to make it a 4-on-2, and Kip
Kiprusoff just gets distracted on that play from Draper coming towards the net. A five-hole goal, a bad goal, a goal you cannot let in a semi or in a final game.
That is not a Kiprusoff goal. No way.
That's the 11th second period goal Canada scored in this tournament. They've only given up two.
Scott Niedermayer gets his first goal of the tournament. 2-1, Canada has taken the lead. And now we will assume that the Finns will open up a little bit. We'll get more flow to this game. Real tough checking to start this second period. Thornton and Draper earning assists on that goal by Niedermayer. Solani is in there now and back the puck up, letting in at the side of the net. And it's fired away with a rebound coming off the pads of Brodeur. And right there was Saku Koivu. But he didn't have a chance to play it. Again, Mario takes the pass outside the Finnish blue line. It came off a leg and back out. Sakic left it. Ginla backed it off the boards again and got it in deep. And that line now will go off for Canada. 2-1 the score. Canada leading in this championship game. And here's Team Canada again getting the zone. St. Louis had to hang on to the blue line, straddling it there, and he couldn't move on the puck when it did get in. Gagne bumped around a bit and lost it. Boomeister hustles back. He's gotten there in time, and that's an icing call against Finland.
Well, neither team has given up many odd man rushes, and that was one, but that wasn't the kind of an odd man rush goal that you see.
No, absolutely. A bad angle shot. You know, it's interesting, Harry. Kiprusoff let a goal like this in the preliminary rounds. It was a very similar angle, a very similar shot. And you have to wonder, perhaps, if Team Canada's gone to school a little bit. Where's his stick? Off the air, but Kiprusoff is halfway. He's on his way down, perhaps guessing a little bit on that shot.
Richards on with St. Louis and Gagne. Finn's making one last change with a stick. That's okay. Canada wins the draw. Fed ahead by Hannon. And it goes high over the glass.
They were having some good offensive zone success. And then Wemo, a bad goal. And can Kiprusoff recover from that? Who knows better than anybody should have.
Cavalier, puck right there in his skates. Now he moves on it to the boards. Cavalier picked it up, tried to go around to the corner and was stopped. Fed in by Heatley a little deeper. Now batted back out. Finland can't clear right away. Coming back quickly is Vananen. He's caught by Vincent Lecavalier. Canada looking a bit sharper now. The puck across in front of the Finnish goaltender. Kiprusoff played back through center ice and Boomeister was back. However, this is Vanden shooting it back in for Finland. Nearing 6 minutes of the second. So it's moving along quickly. Canada with the only goal here in the second period. Niedermayer moments ago, his first. 2-1, Canada leads. Here they come. Up to center, Danny Heatley. Ripped it quickly with a wrist shot. That was on, and Kiprusoff saw that. Not a problem. Out comes Brodeur to play it. Here was back. Fed it up on the boards. It'll be stopped at the blue line. This shot is in wide of the net. Hard shot with traffic in front. Ruutu trying to move it back out. Given the bump. Here comes Berg. He hit his man, and then he fell. Lidman headmans the puck to Jarkko Ruutu. He goes in along the boards and centered it. Two of them are in there. And it's stopped again by Brodeur and cleared out. It's opened up a fair bit now here in the second. San Luis saw his man coming off the line. Gagne! That's stopped by Miikka Kiprusoff. Tipped away to the line this time. Another shot from long distance. That fired by Eric Brewer. Soft though, made the save with the stick. Canada forcing the play again. They're leading 2-1 here in the second. As we come up to the 7 minute mark, and Finland tries to get it back. Solani comes in off the left side this time. A swing at the puck, it goes to the boards in the corner. Tiemannen waits at the line. Here's Solani centering it, but no dice. Easily picked off and lifted away and down the ice by Adam Foote. Pretty solid in front of Brodeur. Finland lining up, five of them. First pass is stopped by Lemieux. Then he wasted needed a little time to move it in and lost it. As Koivu stole it and flipped it back. That's called back out.
I think Kelly Rudy was right when he commented that that first period may have been the best period Lemieux played in this tournament, especially in the last couple of games.
There's Mario again, backhanding the puck inside the line, but that'll be cleared easily. And he stole it. Shot it back in. Kiprusoff had to leave the net. Back quickly is Sammy Salo. Canada keeps it in. Another pass gets to the corner, and here's Sakic. Ripped it. Went for the short side. It hit a leg in front. Again, backed it up for Lemieux, and he was covered. Cleared ahead by Olli Jokinen, and down come the Finns. Led by Jokinen across the line. The high shot is way up over the net. Canada's again got out to center, and he was bumped right there by Ruutu. Brodeur, and looks okay on that one. Playing the pass out. Wolmeister turns. Ginla had to stop. He was checked. Had to get rid of it. Lidman at his own blue line for Finland. Got it away to center. That's across the two lines. And that will be called back.
The 1997 amateur draft, the first five picks are playing in this tournament, in this game. Thornton, Marlowe, Luongo, and Brewer for Canada, and Jokinen for Finland. So congratulations to the scouts who talked their managers into taking those guys 1 through 5.
We have seen a tremendous amount of talent the last couple of weeks in Europe, here in North America. For the World Cup 2004, this is it tonight. Canada leads at the moment by a goal. That man, Niedermeyer, who just made the pass, got the go-ahead goal. It's shot in on Kiprusoff again. They're throwing everything now from outside the line. Here comes Richard's shot. White pad saved that time. Slapping at it was Hintonen. And again, they take their time coming out at center ice. Hagman. He threw it to the middle. Hintonen nearly got in, but he was bumped. Shot around the net by Big Robin Regeer on the other side. Finns are in for checking once more, but it'll be Canada who'll come out with it. Backhanded away across the line by Regeer. Back in for Hagman. Got a shot away. That was a tricky shot that might have changed direction. Brodeur had to be careful to make the save, and he did that. There'll be a faceoff as it goes high up the bench back in the Canadian zone. In quickly is Scott Hannon. He's played well and is rushing well now to center ice. Dumped in wide of the net. And there is Ryan Smith. He got it loose. It's centered. It'll get all the way back to the line. Bullmeister shot it in there again. The Cavalier bumped his man and poked it out front of the net. Finland hanging on, trying to clear it. It gets out all right. And away they go. Hall didn't get too far. He has scored. The Finnish goal came in the first, tying the game at the time. 1-1, 6:34. Sakic had scored at 52 seconds.
Little things that are so important in a game. Ryan Smith beats out on icing here, and here's how he does it. He'll race right in, watch the puck all the time, watch what he does to the stick here. Knocks the stick away first, then gets the puck. A nifty little move by Ryan Smith, and then Le Cavalier protects the puck so well because of his size, and all good players tend to get their rear out and protect the puck because of it.
Thornton again nearly got in there for a shot as he won the faceoff. Koivu gets it out. Down this near side, Lehtinen didn't catch up to the puck, and it's back into the finish zone. Here comes Doan. He backed it up for Thornton, who centered it in the blue ice all right. And then again Thornton after it with Doan. They're working hard in around it. At the other side is Draper. His checking line is doing well. Thornton now, he's dangerous right there. He's waiting. He comes out. The wraparound didn't work. Doan broke his stick. He has to gallop off for the new one. And Finland is allowed to come back in. Salani nearly got in there. It came out over the line and whipped back in by Lehtinen.
It's 3:30 in the morning in Finland. And two charters came over from Helsinki today.
And Finland has caught fire for hockey. They have their own broadcasters here, sending this game back to Finland. Mario Lemieux got the puck in deep again and nearly picked it off on the boards, but here's Olli Jokinen stepping up. Lost it to Lemieux. Good play, and he got it back for Ginla. He couldn't get steady on the puck to get a shot away. Lemieux knew that was going to happen. Centered it again. in there, stopped at the line and kicked ahead. But Jokinen picks it up from Finland and skates out to center ice. He'll go down that far side and leave it for Tuomo Ruutu. In comes Peltonen to help, and again it's Mario Lemieux coming out. A dandy pass once more to Iginla, but once more he couldn't hang on to it. Now he's trying to get his stick down on it, but he was tied up and checked well, and the Finns get the puck to center ice. Bomeister played it ahead. Mario dumped it in. He's gone off. They're changing, and Lemieux gets a hand as he steps to the Canadian bench. 8:45 left to play in the second. This is going to be an icing call. As Bomeister, what a great skater he is, got back in a rush.
Now, Team Canada have to be careful that they don't try and kill the rest of the game off with a one-goal lead. They don't have to gamble like perhaps the Finnish team does. But that next goal for Canada could really put the Finns in an awful spot.
The Brad Richards line on, winning the faceoff inside the line. The pass in front. Saint-Louis ripped it. Big rebound. That was a hard shot by Saint-Louis. Coming very close to scoring there for Canada. Richards again winning that faceoff. Up through center ice. It'll be Timonen who clears it out for Finland. Gagné didn't look. He shot it back in. That's offside. Richards was trapped.
Well, Martin Saint-Louis, who's really had a tough time in the point department in the last two games, gets a good opportunity to make it 3-1 almost right off the faceoff.
Look at how, Harry, he gets into the seam. He wins the draw and then moves away from the dot right into the high slot where there's an area where he can receive the puck. And that was a good chance.
Adam Foote, a little soft pass ahead to Doan. He was body checked off the puck. But Thornton won't be stopped. He's in there again. Made a pass behind the net. Doan is in front. Draper didn't see him right off the bat. Now he does, but it's too late and the play is stopped. And there's going to be a penalty call against Finland.
No, against Canada. Interference in front of the net. Shane Doan knocked the defenseman down. And he will get two or less.
All right. Doan goes. Referee looked back there and pointed right away, and it's trapped Doan. He got him quickly.
In front of the net.
Tripping.
There it is, right there.
Finland 0 for 3 against the USA in the semifinal. And only 5 for 22 total. But this is their big chance now.
Canada penalty number 9, Shane Doan. 2 minutes for tripping. Time of the penalty, 12:05.
So Finland get organized. Jokinen bumped off the puck at center. Ruutu tried to carry in, but that'll be cleared back out. Only as far as center ice, where Finland regroups. Jokinen turns around twice. He has Ruutu to his right. Crowd thought maybe a penalty was coming there to Finland as Iginla was upended. That's Ruutu to pick it up. In behind that icing line and behind the net, the puck is loose and Canada is going to come out with it. Decided to keep skating, kill more time, dump it in gently off the glass, and he heads off. Good penalty kill by Adam Foote. 7 minutes left in the period. Jokinen fires it in. And Brodeur out there, he missed that behind the net. It stopped at the blue line and kept in by Timonen. Fired along the boards. Lettinen tried to get a stick on it. Salani does by coming in and poking it loose. Salani takes a look out, backed it up along the boards and lost it there, and Canada has two going away. Gagné brings it in, gets in a high slot. The shot is off the stick of Salo and off the glass. Now it's played to Koivu. He got away near the line and up as far as center, then was tied up, but poked it to the right wing and comes after it himself. He won't be put on that play. He goes down on the check. And it come back out over the line. Penalty has 20 seconds left. Change by Salani. He nearly got hit with the puck going off. Smith brings it back up for Canada. Dumps it into the corner. Draper went in, knew the hit was coming, took it anyway, and Salo left the puck there. And they move it up smartly. Long pass by Kapanen was good down across the line. The shot. Spread eagle on that one was Brodeur in front again. Just missed on the short side. Canada hangs on and clears it out and down the ice. They're at full strength. They didn't get a shot on goal that time, so this is going to be icing. 5
5:40 left in the period. But the checking continues to be close. It started off that way in this period. Opened up a little bit for about 5 minutes. It's choked off again. Berg shoots the puck around in his own zone and it's played off the boards. Knocked out again. Flynn had to wait. One player was trapped inside the line. Now they're back on side, so in it goes. That's the routine. Brodeur out. Lips a little pass up high. On the boards was Hagman. He missed it. Canada gets it out. Cleared down across the line. Gagne had to wait for help. Finds Saint-Louis, and he got in. Away from one hit. And then gets the puck again and fires it behind the net to Richards. He's tied up. Richards hangs on. Looking around, trying to beat Hagman. Down he goes. Played back out front. Richards left it for Gagne, who set it in front of the net. And that'll be cleared away. Off the boards. Kapanen gets it down to center ice. 4:42 left to play in the second. It's a close one. Richards gets it in and heads off with his line mates. 2-1, that's all. 4:30 remaining in the period. Canada on the attack from the line. Laguerre shot. He broke his stick. It's behind the net. Went high. It bounced down in front of the goal. Kiprusoff wasn't quite sure where it was. Finland get going down to center. Jokinen pokes the puck in on net. And Brodeur nailed it away. But here's a chance for Peltonen. Goes the other way with it. Nobody saw it over there. Up comes Salo to pick it off. Try the shot from this side. Vanenen kept it in. Canada now running around in their own zone. Jokinen just missed picking that one off. It stopped again at the line by Vanenen. He put it in deep. Regeer's back. Chopped it the other way. Lemieux won't get up to it. It's fired in wide of the net. There goes Vanenen again. A big short stays in deep. This is good pressure by Finland. Around the net. Teemu Selanne tried to come out and lost it. It's knocked away by Niedermayer. And Selanne gets a weak shot away. Hit Niedermayer. He's going to just play it back out to center. He nearly hit Sakic with it. But he didn't. He missed him. And the shot back in by Vanenen. That line for Finland is changing them up. Good work by them, though. They had the puck inside the Canadian line for quite some time. This is an icing call against Canada.
Kapanen, Hagman, Hintonen for Finland. Winning the faceoff was Kapanen. He poked the puck at the net, but up high. No icing this time. It's waved off, and they all shot it out for Berg to get back in a hurry. Picked up the line by Hannon. He didn't make good contact on that attempt, and back in for Kapanen. And here's a chance for Hagman. He couldn't get inside, but got the puck again, and now Canada will bring it out. Through the middle they go. Three of them are up, but Smith seems to be hurt and kind of goes off with a limp to the Canadian bench. Hagman for Finland. To center, high one. Dumped in high over Bomeister. That's really high, and that's also an icing call.
Well, Ryan Smith got hit on the right cheek there.
Off the boards for Foote, who takes the shot. Right on, rebound, two steps. Doan had the second one. Gordon again working hard. First pass doesn't work, so he goes back to try it again. And does get the puck out. Joe Thornton fired it in. Doan around the net. Tried to go back up with it to Thornton and did. And Thornton goes around to the corner. Plays it back. And Finland will pick it up and clear the puck up to the line. Hint just waited and then fired it up. But Koivu didn't have a stick. He played it anyway with a skate well over the line. He has to go off. Doan back up. That's on the catching glove of Kiprusoff. Lemieux missed it over there. Stays with it though. Tried to hook it ahead. That's lifted away by Finland all the way down the ice. And hurrying back is Niedermayer. You better watch it. Alarantha is right on him. But he heard him come and got the puck out. Up through center ice. Canada moving in. It's again Niedermayer trying a shot on goal. That stopped this time by Kiprusoff. Far corner again. I couldn't move it. And it's fired away by Salo once more. Finland up. Center ice. Hall threw it in, headed off, and they are changing. Only 1:15 left in the period. Canada has a one-goal lead. Again, the checking gets rather close. No great rushes going on here. Ruutu trying one. He might do it. He's in.
He scores! Tuomo Ruutu was allowed to walk in there with 1 minute left. He beats Brodeur, and this game is tied.
Boy, this Ruutu's been very impressive tonight. A physical player who really had a terrific second half last year. And this is a solo mission, as you can see. He steps by Richards, then steps by Gagne, then steps by Niedermeyer, and then puts it by Brodeur. So a one-on-three, four if you want to count the goalie. Not a smooth goal till now. And he ties the hockey game with exactly a minute to go on the best individual rush I've seen in this tournament.
Gagne and Niedermeyer go fishing for the puck instead of taking the body, but a great play by Ruutu on the glove side of Martin Brodeur.
Tuomo Ruutu, number 15 for Finland. Lidman will get one assist. The 19-minute mark, the game is tied. Canada better be careful. Finland is attacking again. High one goes down the ice. That's Ruutu's first goal of the tournament. What a goal it is. Finns try to get something else going before the period is done. They have 30 seconds left on the clock, and they're in their own zone. 2-2 the score. Saku Koivu. First pass, and here's the second for Tiemann. Dumped on the boards across center ice, in and over the Canadian line. Brodeur will wait back there. Nobody open. Now he finds his man, Gagne, and he fires it in. At the line, it's offside with 9 seconds remaining.
Now the big question is Marty Brodeur Marty Brodeur right now? He's used to making those saves at big times of the game, albeit Ruutu with a great shot in a perfect scoring position. And by the way, Canada was on a bad change there, but it really didn't matter anyway. They were changing coming into the zone, but as you mentioned, Harry, it was still a one-on-three.
Three or four mistakes. Ends up in the net.
3 seconds to go. After 40 minutes, nothing has been solved with these two finalists. They've just dropped the puck to start the third period, and the game tied 2-2. Finland starting up from the left. Dumped in along the boards for Solani, who's coming in after it hard. Solani bumps his man, who goes down, and Canada turns it back up. Three of them, led by Joe Thornton over the line. He's had a strong game so far. Thornton has. It's fired in off the boards to the corner. And Foot was pinching in and make it deep for Thornton up front. Doan scores! Wow! Thornton, what did I say? What a play by Joe Thornton! Doan gets the goal at 34 seconds.
Well, this line's done a marvelous job. They've held the Koivu, Lehtinen, Solani line to no points and two shots. And this line has been on the ice for two goals, including this one. Thornton to Doan. So the checking line has a goal and three assists. The line they're checking has nothing.
Puck in along the boards and shot high over the crossbar. And Finland coming back hard to try and tie it again. Shot by Peltonen is blocked. Canada gets it up through center ice. Nice play, goes in there for Sakic again. Sakic can't get a shot away. Lemieux was up there with him. It was he who had passed it in to Sakic, but he got checked immediately. Finn's back, and Brodeur out to cut the angle on a good attempt by Tuomo Ruutu again.
Kepo Numanen got caught on this play, not in front of the net. The rule of thumb is you better have a defenseman in front of the net. And there's a battle up on the half boards. And there's Numanen up the top of your screen. He's trying to take the position of the winger instead of getting parked in front of the net. He's far too late, and Doan is left wide open for a gift.
So Canada has taken the lead again, 3-2 this time. Gagne in. Richards bumps his man. Gagne centered it. That was a close call. Kiprusoff not sure where the puck is. Now he does know where it is, and he has it smothered, but that was another close call by this Canadian line of Richards and Saint-Louis and Gagne.
So this line has not been able to put many pucks in lately, but they nearly score here. Gagne gets it out in front. Now you can see Kiprusoff made the save, but he didn't know where the puck was.
They saw one by Canada, then they cough it up to Finland. There's the crowd on the boards again. Bomeister's going to shoot it. That's onto the blocker. Kiprusoff to the corner. Richards comes up with it. Centers it again. In close. Gagne hit the side of the net. Again, good pressure by this trio. Richards, Gagne, and Saint Louis. Bomeister had to reach and had to back off. Hentonen got going. And he made the play back in front. The shot by Kapanen was wide of the net. Canada nearly going to break the other way with Saint Louis just missing the puck. Coming near center ice. 2 minutes gone in the third. Canadians pick it off. Saint Louis shot that in and took off to the bench. On the ice again for Ryan Smith on the forecheck. Up with him with Cavalier. Ryan Smith chases his man. But they get it out and down the ice. No icing. Eric Brewer picks it up and shoots it around his own goal. It's not out. Kept in. Hall had one chance. Failed to get a shot. Dumped deep and Brewer back. Gets loose off the boards. Nice play by the Finnish winger Ruutu. Got it off the boards and then in deep again. Shot in there by Koivu. Erko Ruutu with him. And on the ice is Elorad. He tried to knock it loose. I think he broke his stick. He stays there. They call the play.
Ryan Smith was down and wanted the faceoff. He needed a line change. He wasn't going anywhere with it. Elorada broke the stick trying to pull the puck out. Canada has done a nice job on faceoffs in their own end for the most part, so it's never a bad play, especially when you're tired like Smith.
Solani trying to get loose, grabbed from behind. Play is allowed to continue. They get the puck to the line and out. Nearly a 2-on-1. Doan is up again with Draper this time on the other side. It was Thorpe, but the pass was behind him. Picked off at center ice, and Canada moves up again. Quickly, Regeer got it ahead to Thornton. Coming in, Thornton didn't get the pass for the crowd in front. Regeer stopped it, and Thornton got a shot on goal. I'll tell you that Kiprusoff looked a little shaky on that.
And Salo gets his big toe on the puck, or that would have been a scoring chance for Team Canada, but they still get one and another turnover by Finland.
Just did get by Jay Bomeister. Look at Ruutu skate in there and hit him. Big defenseman. Ruutu not that big, but he can fly. And here's Sakic, who also moves it perfectly. Got it in for Lemieux, who shot it deep, and Sakic anticipating the move, got in there first. Sakic gets the puck loose. Out front is again Sakic's backhander. Stop! And it's whipped away, and Bomeister was in too far, pinching in, and the puck got by him. Tuomo Ruutu brings it back up. Look over the line for Jokinen. His shot, not much on that at all. He gets another chance on it. He left it there on the boards, tried to get it away from Mario Lemieux. It's in behind the Canadian net, and Scott Hannon waits back there. He's starting to move up with it. Hannon coming straight to the line. The puck well. You didn't see the pass, however. And Hintonen brings it back in over the line, and the play is whistled dead. It's a hand pass, and they'll call that back.
Finland doesn't get it back for quite a little while. And there's the backhand that Simon Kiprusoff.
Richards line on again for Canada. Kapanen didn't get it out. Stopped at the blue line. Brewer's shot easily blocked. And Brewer has to wait now at the center ice area. Did do that and flipped it ahead. Gagne will move up along the boards against Lidman, but the play again is called back up. There have only been two penalties called in the game, one to either team, and not a shot recorded on the two power play. Right to the net. Blocker save, Kiprusoff. Finns get it down to center ice. That's all. Ruutu couldn't move very far. He's on the boards, jammed there. Regeer stepped up from the blue line. He got it again, though. Ruutu and lost it. Fed into the zone, and Dan Heatley is coming in hard. Heatley bumped two men in there, and he gave Smith a chance to play it, but Finland will bring it away. Lifted out by Ruutu, and he was hit on the boards by Le Cavalier, who takes the pass. Ahead, it goes to Smith. Takes the shot, nowhere near the net with that one. And Koivu will bring it away for Finland. The captain put it up center. That pass didn't work. Two teams are making changes. 5.5 minutes gone in the third. Canada leads by a goal. Biggest spread in the game. One goal. That's all. Finland kept coming back as Canada scored. Can they come back again? Well, two of them are up there at center. Sanani found his man coming in off the wing. Turning in front of the net was... Man, he didn't see it at all. They checked him and got the puck back out. Checking is getting a little close now, but Finland can't afford to keep that little tech going. They're down a goal. Time rolls on here in the third period in this championship game. They're capable of exploding. It's a quick team. And out they come. Numanen comes to center and dumped it in, but that time Jokinen was too fast in there. And he's offside on that three-man rush. Lidman moves up with a quick pass. Off a skate, it's out. Lidman poked it ahead again. They do get back on side, but Canada's Brodeur starts up and moves to the line. Backhands it on the boards to center. Lemieux is covered very well. They got to watch him. Sakic is with him, of course. And Ginla is on the other side. Lemieux gives it to Sakic. Ginla, a little bit too long for him. He goes in to pick it up, though. Gets in around the net. Two defenders on him, and Finland will come up with it. Around the goal is Jokinen. Goes to the corner, fired by Berg, and it gets out to center ice. Finland trying to catch up. It was a one-man rush with Ruutu going in. Centering pass, Ruutu tried to hit his man behind the net and missed him. And he got a number taken, I believe, as Mario checked him out. At center ice, Big Brodeur is hammered. Tuomo Ruutu is hitting everything and is moving in the red shirt. Fired to the corner. Sell. Gagne stopped that, but couldn't do much with it. Now he has to wait. Did he wait long enough? No, he did not. Offside.
But the Draper line, Draper, Thornton, and Doan, boy, what a job they've done since they've been given the checking assignments. And they have 4 points, as well as keeping the Koivu line right off the board.
Puck comes as far as center. Lehtinen just watched it go by him. In comes Hintonen to take it around the net. Pass back out. Juri Lehtinen trying to move it in again, and Canada takes over in the zone. They don't get it too far. It's still in deep. Up comes Hintonen once again. He leaves it. Kapanen out for Hintonen. No shot. He's knocked down. Gets back up. Rolled it around the net. Sanomi will have to hurry over there if he hates. He likes to beat team, and then he doesn't get there in time. Finland on it in front of the net. They save as Lehtinen came on strong right for the net. And Brodeur shut the door. That's his best. Still a one-goal game, Canada. Brodeur will hang on to this one by scooping it up with that sore wrist and all, and he hangs on.
Well, he knew his team needed a rest. They got back in their own end and couldn't control the Finns on the forecheck. But when he got a chance to freeze the puck on an easy shot, not that one, he did.
But a big save there on Lehtinen in the slot, and that's the Marty Brodeur I know. Big saves at big times in a hockey game.
This is a big time in this big hockey game. You're right. Right. There's another one off the pad. Knocked down in front, though, and scooping at it. There's Draper, and he got it out in a hurry. Here he takes the puck now. Steams in over the line. Draper, full head of steam, coming in around the net. Coming out, leaves it. Played back in for Thornton around the goal. Doan is over there. He's got the go-ahead goal for Canada here in the third. There's Thornton. That skipped over his stick. Took a hop behind the net, and he missed it. Salani backed up. Bumped by Doan. Here comes Thornton. He nailed his man. But Finland will move it up. And the captain, Koivu, played it through to Salani, and he joins the rush with him. Salani goes to the net. Koivu lost the puck. Salani stays in. Now they're headed off, I think, and Canada regrouping deep in their own zone. Up for Robin Revere. Quick pass. Gets to Lemieux. He sets it up there. Again, rebound. Right off Kiprusoff, and a big rebound it was. Good setup again. But back in for Ilaranta. He's cutting inside. And that is stopped. That was Jokinen who made that rush. And up comes Numanen. Lemieux again somehow spotted the move. And look at it. He saw Ginla taking off with Sakic. And he comes up to join the rush. Lemieux's foot, rather, the backhander going in. Lemieux had gone to the bench. They didn't get that far. first to go. Sakic now, and here goes Ginland. That line is gone. Two good rushes by them as we come up to the halfway mark of the third. Numanen plays it rink wide. Finland trying to get the tying goal. Lehtinen comes up on the play. Around the net, Hintonen. Big collision back there, and Bomeister takes it. Gets the puck out. His defense partner took everybody out of the play. And again, Brodeur is going to hang on to this for fear of a rebound with Hintonen coming right at him from the other side. On the bench, and the faceoff in the Canadian zone. Doan gets it out. Draper didn't see the pass, went in behind him. Numanen plays it up for Finland. Salani was right there at the Canadian blue line. Back down the ice. Koivu backed it up. Now it's gloved down by Draper, and he shoots it in. He takes off to Gwynn, but he won't get near the puck. Koivu shot it away. It's batted to center ice, and Foot stops it again. 3-2, Canada leads. 9:25 left to play in the third. Canadians give it away to Numanen and his defense partner. However, that's dumped down the ice from the other side of the center ice, and that's an icing call. And you wonder how the nerves are taking it all. There's the executive people, Wayne, along with Kevin Law, Steve Tambellini.
That's who Finland should draft with 8 minutes to go. He might pop one in for you.
Sakic can't win the faceoff. There goes Vanden, played it ahead for Finland. He got it out. That's all. Canada regrouping. Here, reach for it. Mario knocked it in. Ginla trying to catch out Vanden and jumps in there ahead of him. And the puck is stopped at the line and the pins come out. They're trading by a goal. Now it's lifted in deep again by Olli Jokinen. And there, Peltonen stopped behind the net. Finland moving up, and Mario once again playing a strong defensive role. Stole the puck, and it's shot in on the blocker of Kiprusoff, and Lemieux went off. Finland back. On the offside, Donnier did not see San Luis trapped on the big circle.
Well, we witnessed Mario's soft hands and a beautiful pass to a Ginland moments ago. I talked to him this morning. He said the one thing he's had trouble catching up with is in tight plays. But he said it was coming. Well, here's a good example of a nice tight play where he picks the pocket of his opposition and finds, guess who? A Ginland once again storming up the middle of the ice.
Sees everything. No doubt about that. He used to say that about Wayne. To see the entire ice. Great players. Bobby Orr. Mario, of course, does it too.
They can see out of their ears.
Yep. Yep. It's amazing. Canada 3, Finland 2. Finland starts up. San Luis missed intercepting that pass. Coming in was Ruutu. Jarkko Ruutu was tied up, couldn't get loose for it. Centering it was Hall, and didn't work either. Ruutu behind the net. Bomeister poked at it. Ruutu gets it again. Brings it back out. That stopped this time by San Luis, and he got it up to center ice. Can't move on it though. Ruutu played it back for Timonen, and he just shot it into the Canadian zone. Out was Brodeur to make the pass up. Smith wasn't quite ready for that and just dumped it over the line. Kapanen turns around in his own zone and played the puck ahead. That's down to the far side for Hintonen coming in. Stopped outside the Canadian line as they move up again. Heatley gets the puck across center and shoots it in for the Cavalier who took the hit. Heatley keeps coming. Can't reach it. And Salani was tied up, but that's okay. Cleared back out by Kapanen and down the ice. Adam Foot back there again. Always steady. Got it up to Heatley. Heatley trying to shoot it in. Ended. And they're turning to the bench. 7:05 left in the third. It's a one-goal game. 3-2, Canada. Crowd anxious for another score by the Canadians, of course. The sellout crowd. You can hear them roaring, "Let's go, Canada!" Well, Eloranta trying to do something about it now for Finland, and he finds a hard hit from Regier, and he's down and he's hurt. He's still down, getting back to his knees. Finland can't get the stick near a puck, and it's back out. Big hard hit by the big Canadian defenseman. Robin Regard, up goes Draper. In over the line, he goes and dropping it back. Here comes the shot, and it's gloved by Kiprusoff. Mikko Eloranta, Sol getting to the bench, too.
6:25 left. Tension mounting. World Cup on the line tonight. Finland, surprise finalist by many people, but they deserve to be here. Kiprusoff had two shutouts early. Here of the U.S. And now moving out to center, Salo. Nice pass to get him going.
5:52 to go. Suman has done a pretty good job with this group, Harry.
Not easy to coach the players of these caliber. They're all stars for their team. And some of them have a tough time getting a lesser assignment in this tournament than they would in the Stanley Cup playoffs or the season.
McGeer steps up and gives the pass to Joe Sakic. In deep on the other side, they move in after it. Lemieux comes in to help. They don't get the puck back to him. He was all wide open by himself back there, but Ginla didn't know it. Now Lemieux, back for Lemieux, turning at the line. Ginla is in deep. Here comes Sakic to steal it. The other way. Ginla was tied up and couldn't move on it. It'll be played out by Ruutu. Finland clearing the zone. 5:10 left. One goal game. Tuomo Ruutu, who scored in the second period. With 1 minute left to tie the game at that point at 2-2. Doan scored at 34 seconds starting this third. That's the story to now. Will it hold up? Brodeur out of the net. Fires it away himself. It gets to the line, and Lidman knew that, moved up on it. He couldn't keep it in, though. Open ice, a race for it. It's got to be Doan. Boy, he's striding hard. But he lost it on that poke check, and Koivu dropped it back. That won't work. As Adam Foote is in front of Koivu. And now Eric Brewer. Under 5 minutes left. Draper tossed the puck ahead. It's Thornton who pokes it further down the ice. Tiemannen brings it back up for Finland. Getting through center, he weaves his way nicely and dumps it in, and Brodeur will play the puck a lot now. He gets it up on the boards. San Luis lost it back there. Finland fired it right at the net. And Brodeur was back on the pipe on that side. And he makes the save with 4:07 remaining.
Well, Shane Doan put Canada in front for the third time in this game with a goal at the 34-second mark of the third period. And Canada got three goals early in periods. Doan that one, Sakic at 52 seconds of the first, and Niedermeyer at 3:15 of the second.
Face off. Crowd after the puck. Finland gets it. Long shot right on by Kimmo Tiemannen. He blasted that one from just inside the blue line. It was right on. Brodeur saw it and made the save.
Well, when you let the goalie see the shot as far away as this one was taken, even though Canada lost a scramble draw, you're not going to score on Brodeur from there very often.
Riku Hall, who has a goal in this game, the first one, the opening period for Finland. Got the goal to tie it when Sakic opened the scoring for Canada. Bollmeister shoots it around the net. Lemieux backs up in his own zone deep. Now everybody aware of what might happen in there, and they're all back. So out to center, Tiemannen. Flipped it up on the boards to the right. That'll get in, and Bollmeister seeing a lot of ice time now. This young man starts away. Look at him go. He's a dandy. Jay Bollmeister is a good one. Comes in with the brakes on in the corner and couldn't make the play off Lidman. But it's in. Centering pass didn't work at the blue line. Hooked in deep by Scott Niedermeyer. Around the net it goes, and they're changing now. Canada is. Finland coming up with 3:23 remaining in the third period. Finland on it was Hagman. Took a little bump going after the puck. Four players on the boards. And it is still inside the line, and now Canada will bring it out. Little pass gets up there for Richards. Drops it back in front. Here's Gagne! Rebound! That's knocked down by Kiprusoff twice. Canada coming close to icing the cake. On under 3 minutes left to play in the third period for the World Cup of Hockey. Canada attacking. Another quick pass. Now Richard shot. That stopped. Another rebound given up by Kiprusoff, but nobody could move on it. Finland trying to get that long pass working now. And they're good at that. Gagne stopped that one and sends it in deep with 2:40 left in the third period. Finland back to pick it up. 3-2 Canada. Pass comes off the boards and Canadians are watching every move now by the white-shirted Finns. Shot in deep, Ben Lidman is back to start it off for Finland. That pass to Teemu Selanne and he's dancing through center. He fanned on it, the shoot-in. And who's with him? Shane Doan, that's who. And he just played it ahead. What a game he's playing for Canada tonight. He's got the go-ahead goal as it stands now. 34 seconds in this third period. Canada changing quickly. And Teemu Selanne firing the puck up the center ice. Finland being checked into the ice now by these Canadian players. 2 minutes left. Around the net as Adam Foote plays it on this side for Lemieux. Lemieux waits, takes a look, goes to the glass. That won't get out. They've tried to get it out. Lemieux decides the best thing to poke it back, and he did to Brodeur. Brodeur takes it, ripped it on the glass. Ahead, Aginla, all tied up. Aginla again shoots it to center ice, 1:40 left. Kiprusoff not moving yet. It's shot in on the net, and Brodeur stops that. Cleared on the boards, but not out. Lemieux, dog-tired, went off on that last shift and looked back, and he's back on again. Brodeur watching that one go to the right.
They're going to call a timeout now, and it's done by Finland.
Finland has called a 30-second timeout.
Shots in the period are 12-9. Canada seems like more than that.
It does. Canada's done an excellent job in this period, just sending one man in, plugging up the neutral zone. I can only count one very good chance by Finland in this period. It was Jari Lehtinen in the slot, and Brodeur made an excellent save. Other than that, Bob, they played a letter-perfect defensive period. 1:29 left to carry on with it.
All right, gentlemen, when is the time that Kiprusoff will be called? He's 20 feet out of the net now in front of the blue ice. 1:29 left on the clock. The face-off is coming inside the Team Canada blue line. If they should win the face-off and get the puck deeper, likely you'll see Miikka Kiprusoff get to the bench.
It's always good to see who the coaches trust on situations like this, especially if the team with the one goal lead.
Canada 3, Finland 2. Not fairly. They tell me today in Helsinki, everybody was calling in and telling their employers they'll be sick tomorrow or up all night watching this game. Well, they're seeing a dandy. And now here we go. Face-off won by Canada. Can they move it out? Yes, Regier dumps it out. Kiprusoff backs up. Canada gets in there. A good work by Joe Sakic, but he fell. Can he hang on to it? He's doing a pretty good job on Timonen. Now it's grabbed by the Jokinen and fired away. Finns are on the move. There goes the goaltender, Kiprusoff. They'll get the extra man on now as the puck is shot in deep. And they're all in there looking for it. But Canada has it on the boards. Not out. Shot by Salo. That's knocked down. Salo steps up again. We are in the final minute of this game. Canada leads by a score of 3-2. 52 seconds left for the World Cup. Down around the net again. A center right in front of the goal. And that's a nice play by Aginla. Empty net down there for Aginla. He'll go high with it. Gently, though, so that there'll be no icing. 40 seconds remaining. Canada changing. Finland changing. Jokinen brings it up and he gets to center and lost it. Empty net. A good play by seconds left in this one. World Cup on the line. Canada, can they hang on? Six attackers on for Finland and the crowd roaring here in Toronto. 18 seconds away from winning this baby. It's shot away to center ice and Finland is on it to dump it in. The dangerous Teemu Selanne is coming, but there's Brodeur out of the net. 8 seconds remaining. Can they do it? They're fighting hard in there, this Finnish team. 3 seconds, Canada.